NHS, our fabulous doctors, junior doctors, and nurses, and porters, and physiotherapists kept me alive and tens of thousands of others like me. So we've all got to say that whilst we fight in this general election to kick out the Tories, whatever happens, we must all commit to fight to defend our NHS, kick out the private sector, and for decent conditions for all of those people who work on our behalf. The comments, we've lived under a Tory government now since 2010. And I just want to mention a couple of groups of PCS workers to show you how bad life is if you work in the public sector under the Tories. Now our members keep this country going, from collecting tax to paying benefits to keeping our country safe. But we've got some groups of workers who are treated so shamefully that they're having to campaign now for things that we should be able to take for granted. First of all, after me, you're going to hear a speaker from the Equality and Human Rights Commission, and our colleagues are down here. Now, we have just authorised as a union 20 days of strikes to come in the EHRC. There's already been 6 or 7 days of strike action over the fact that the EHRC as an employer is making compulsory redundancies and cuts that are making the worst fall disproportionately on our black and minority ethnic members, disabled members, and disgracefully, trade union activists. So when you hear the speaker today for the HRC, give her a massive, massive welcome. And when we do the collections in the weeks to come, give generously, because this is a critical dispute. I hope you all agree, we want to see victory to the EHRC, PCS members, and be back here next year celebrating like we were when we were last year when our National Gallery members were on strike for 100 days against privatisation and trade union victimisation. But I also want to mention another group of workers, those members who work in the Tate Gallery. Now these are members who are fighting against 0 hours contracts, privatisation and poverty wages. And they've been unlucky enough to be working under the reign of Nicholas Sirota, who is now retiring as the director. And his legacy for our members has been misery at work. And we've had to campaign to get justice and dignity for those staff. Yeah. And you know now as he's leaving, the management have asked all staff to give into his leaving present bucket collection to buy him a new boat. But what does that tell you about inequality in Britain today? The workers who have been treated shamefully for years have to put money in a bucket for Nicholas Sirota to have his boat so he can go sailing around the waters wherever he chooses. I hope you agree with me that as Nicholas Sirota sails off into the distance, we should commit ourselves to fight for justice for workers in the culture sector who are displaying some of Britain's greatest cultural assets whilst being treated absolutely shamefully. So let's have justice for all gallery and culture sector workers across the UK. Now, comrades, you just heard John McDonnell. I'm not going to repeat what he said, but I would say this to you. The last time we had a general election in this country, and Labour was led by Ed Miliband and Ed Balls as the Shadow Chancellor, we were asked to vote Labour, and we were told it meant keeping a public sector pay freeze, keeping a freeze on public expenditure, and keeping austerity in Britain. How refreshing is it, therefore, that 2 years on, we go into this election with Jeremy Corbyn and the Labour Party saying they will end 0 hours contracts, repeal the anti-union legislation, fund the NHS, lift the public sector pay cap, and ensure there is dignity at work for all of us. Yes. Now we should never take that for granted. How many May Days have we been to where that has never been on offer from the Labour Party? So I'm quite happy to say to all of us here and everybody around the country, if you care about public services, if you care about fighting inequality and our NHS, you care about education, we need to vote for Jeremy Corbyn and Labour next month and do everything we can to kick out the Tories. The final thing I want to say is this. Whatever happens in the general election, and we hope that we get rid of Theresa May, there's a lot of people who are demoralised at the moment and actually think there's been years of attack upon attack and they don't know where to look next. And we in the trade union movement have a responsibility to say this. Whilst we want to vote out Theresa May, we also have a responsibility to say whatever happens, the unions have got to get off their knees and have got to start fighting together against cuts, privatisation and pay restraint. So my appeal here is this. For 4 years running at the TUC, we've carried a unanimously a motion from PCS that's called for coordinated strikes across the public sector to defeat the government's pay policy. Yes. And it hasn't happened. And what we get as a result is our members 20% off in real terms worse off, nurses and teachers struggling to make ends meet. And if the Tories win the election, that policy will stay until at least 2020. So the call of my union to all unions is this. Now is the time to fight to end poverty pay in the public sector. And if all unions across health, local government, education and the civil service all take strike action together, we can defeat any pay policy that Theresa May tries to impose on us if she wins the election. So our message has to be this. Vote Labour and fight to get Theresa May out. But if she does win, we will fight like never before, together, for justice for working people, for public sector workers, and our future can be bright if we fight together and campaign together. Greetings, comrades, to everyone. Give a big reaction to our speakers from PCS, from the HRC, and let's fight like never before. Happy May Day.